Hey guys, welcome back to Sports Hack TV. Let's talk about a couple of interesting stories today. We begin with John Jones. John Jones posted this physique update a few days ago, guys, and I must say, he looks very impressive. John says he's weighing in at 240 pounds. If you converted, it's 109 kilos. And compared to the tall and lanky build he used to have when fighting at 205 pounds, it's obvious he's packed on at least 10 to 15 pounds of lean muscle. Now, how John packed on that much lean muscle in 3 months is beyond me. Currently, John is training to capture the gold in the heavyweight division, which I feel is very possible. If you look at the stats with the current heavyweight champ, Stipe Miocic, he's a great wrestler and very good at striking as well, especially at countering his opponent's punches and attacking when backing up. A clear example would be when Stipe knocked out Werdum when he was being attacked and pushed back and just ended it with one blow. That takes immense accuracy, which is very rare among heavyweights, and what makes the matchup between John Jones and Stipe exciting is both are similar in terms of the height and weight. John is amazing at his striking, including his ground game, so it'll be interesting to see how John fares against one of, if not the best heavyweight in the UFC. Currently, the champ most probably might fight Francis Ngannou, so let's see how it turns out, guys. The only thing more exciting than John vs Stipe is John fighting Francis. Now that's something which might break a lot of pay-per-view records in the UFC. Now, if you're enjoying this video, please support me by liking and subscribing down below and do comment as well, guys. Moving on towards our next news update. Jan Błachowicz wants Israel Adesanya. We've seen from the last couple of months, Israel Adesanya, who is the current undefeated middleweight champ in the UFC, has been wanting to get a crack at the light heavyweight belt against John Jones. Israel's been attacking John on social media and in interviews asking for a fight, but John Jones responded recently by saying he doesn't gain anything by beating Adesanya, justifying his decision to move to heavyweight. Jan Błachowicz is the current light heavyweight champ after John vacated the title. I think the fight between Jan and Israel might be set up for the first quarter of 2021. Recently, Jan sent a warning to Israel by saying, I quote, "All my life I'm in this category, so I know everything about this category. Everything is different. Cardio is different. Timing is different. Speed is different. You can train with heavyweight guys, you can train with 205 pound guys, but this is training. A fight is completely different. When guys change their category, they've got problems with that. Problems with everything. Not everyone can be ready for that." Warning that Adesanya might be in over his head at light heavyweight. I tend to lean a little towards what Jan is saying here, but don't forget, Israel is an undefeated UFC champ with over 80 fights if you factor in his UFC and kickboxing career. So Israel is a dangerous guy for anybody in any weight class. He's very tall and has got the reach advantage over most of his opponents, which are bonus points for him. I believe if both of them face off, Israel will definitely have the advantage when it comes to the stand-up and the speed, whereas Błachowicz is more of a brawler. We also came to know recently Minotauro Nogueira was hospitalized with pneumonia. Now for people who don't know, Nogueira is regarded as one of the best heavyweight MMA fighters of all time. He starred in Pride Fighting Championships from 2001 to 2006 before moving to UFC, where he competed from 2007 to 2015. Minotauro retired in 2015 following a 3-fight win streak. Currently he serves as one of UFC's ambassadors in Brazil. Well, according to the report released on Thursday, Nogueira was kite surfing when he became exhausted and was sent to the hospital for further evaluation. Currently, Nogueira is admitted and undergoing a couple of tests in a hospital in Fortaleza. Well, I sincerely hope Big Nog recovers from this and gets back to normal as soon as possible. Now for our final update, we've got news that Conor McGregor and Manny Pacquiao are working on a boxing match next year. Now, to those who are unaware of Manny, he's the only 8 division world champion in the history of boxing, guys, and has won 12 major world titles. This makes him one of the greatest boxers to ever live. To top that, he's the current senator of the Philippines and is also a popular film actor back in his home country. Manny Pacquiao's side released a statement saying the bout will take place with the part of the fighter's earning going to COVID-19 relief in the Philippines, which kind of sums up the kind of man Pacquiao is. Now, nothing is signed on paper as of yet, but if the fight does take place, it'll draw a huge number of fans around the world to see the fight and also generate a lot of pay-per-view buys. If you look back on Conor's previous boxing match, he fought Floyd Mayweather. He made $100 million for that, so I figure he's gonna make the same, if not more money from this fight. Joe Rogan, who is a famous UFC commentator, said on his podcast that Manny Pacquiao is going to destroy Conor McGregor if they fight. I tend to somewhat agree with Joe here, but the same thing was said about the fight between Conor and Floyd. Conor may have lost the fight, but he did land a few hard hits on Floyd, which Manny couldn't. So anything is possible between these two. I give Manny the advantage to win, but if Conor can knock out Manny Pacquiao, whoa, that'll be something fight fans will remember for a long time. Well, that's it from me for today's video, guys. Do share, subscribe, and like the video if you've enjoyed it. And don't forget to click the bell icon to get instant notifications about my latest videos. Bye-bye, guys, and as always, take care.